Hello everyone, I'm Ihsan. In this video, we'll be sharing 10 initial settings for the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra. But before we get into that, let's do a quick unboxing of the Samsung S22 Ultra. Then here we will also share tips on the initial settings when you first turn on your Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra out of the box. As for the design of the box itself, it appears to feature a minimalist black design with the word Samsung on the right side. On the left side, there is the text Galaxy S23 Ultra. And in front of it, there is a picture of the smartphone with the same color as the one inside the box. Inside the Samsung S23 Ultra box, besides the smartphone, we also got a user manual, a USB Type-C to Type-C cable, and a SIM card ejector tool. Here, the color of the S23 Ultra that we are unboxing in this video is green. The green color of the S23 Ultra series that we are unboxing in this video looks soft and elegant. The design of the rear camera also feels more premium and luxurious with the addition of thicker camera ring. Although the camera design changed slightly on the S23 Ultra series, however, the positions of the buttons and ports look exactly the same as on the previous series. On the right hand side, there is a volume button and power button. Then at the bottom, there is a SIM tray slot which can only be used for dual nano SIM cards. Then there is a USB Type-C speaker and also S Pen slot on the left. The design of the S Pen and its features haven't changed and are still the same as in the previous series. On the left side is empty and at the top there is only a microphone hole. When we turn on the smartphone for the first time from the box, there are some new settings that we find. There are several new settings that we have never found on other Samsung smartphone before. In this initial setting, after selecting the language and agreeing to the license agreement, you'll find a new settings for transferring data from the previous phone. Here immediately appears the option to transfer data directly from Android or from iPhone and also from iPad. For Android smartphone, here all you have to do is scan the barcode that is displayed on the smartphone screen. Then at the end of the setting, there is also a new settings or option that we have also never found before. In this latest series, you are now asked directly to choose your preferences for light mode or dark mode for the appearance of your smartphone. Now for those who prefer dark mode, you can really select the settings at the beginning of the initial settings when you first turn on your Samsung smartphone. And now for the entire setting process when you first turn on the smartphone is finished. And then let's dive into the initial setting tips for the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra. For the first initial setting tips, you can immediately change the navigation bar to swipe gestures to maximize the use of the widescreen on the S23 Ultra series. You can change these settings directly in the display settings, then select navigation bar and select swipe gestures. For the options at the bottom, we usually only activate switch apps when hidden. For other options, we just disable it to optimize the screen usage experience. And after activating this feature, navigation on the screen can be easier without the need for a navigation button. To go back, simply swipe on the left or right edge of the screen, and to return to the home screen, you can swipe up from the bottom of the screen. Then the second setting is to customize the wallpaper display on both home screen and lock screen. When you change the wallpaper on the S23 Ultra, there are several exclusive wallpaper designed for the S23 Ultra series. You can also directly apply the wallpaper as the lock screen wallpaper. When you change the wallpaper for both the home screen and lock screen, there is a home button at the bottom that allows you to preview how the wallpaper looks on the home screen. For the lock screen clock display, there are several phone options that you can choose from. You can also adjust the size of the clock to make it smaller or larger. Then on the lock screen settings, you can also add your contact information, which will be displayed on the S23 Ultra lock screen. For the display of notifications that appear on the lock screen, you can also select the icon only or details. And in this latest version, there is also an option that is none, which removes all notification icons on the lock screen display. Here you can simply choose the type of notification display that appears on the lock screen based on your own preference. Then moving on to the third tip is that you can first update the Galaxy Store application to the latest version. It will allow you to update all system applications related to One UI 5.1 directly from Galaxy Store. After pressing the update button, you just need to wait for the update process to finish. Once you have successfully updated the Galaxy Store application to the latest version, then open the application again and click on the menu. From there, select the updates option. If you haven't logged in to your Samsung account, you can do so directly from this menu. And if you don't have a Samsung account, you can create one and then log in to the Galaxy Store application. Then after successfully creating a Samsung account, you can immediately log in to your Samsung account on the Galaxy Store. From there, you can click on the menu and select the updates option. And in this view, you can easily update all system applications to the latest version. Then the next setting is to activate Light Performance Profile. This feature can be very useful in certain situations, such as when you don't need high performance on your smartphone and want to save on battery usage. You can find the Light Performance mode in the Battery and Device Care settings. Then select the battery menu and you can scroll to the very bottom and select more battery settings. Here you can select the performance profile and find the option for light performance. By activating the light performance mode will cause the chipset to operate at a lower clock speed. And of course it will save more battery on your smartphone than the standard setting. Next you can add a shortcut to access the light performance mode easily directly from the control panel. To do so, simply click the plus sign on the right side of the control panel and add an icon called Performance Profile. For shortcuts to other important features in the control panel, you can also add them directly in this setting. Once you have finished adding them, simply click the Done button. Then you can now activate the Light Performance mode directly from the control panel very quickly. If the icon for Performance Profile is active, it means the light mode is running. And if the icon is disabled, it means the standard mode is running. And then the next tip is to activate the Labs feature in the Advanced feature setting. Here these 4 options are important and very useful. For those of you who use the S23 Ultra, especially those who frequently use split screen and pop-up view modes to open apps, by activating this feature, you can immediately activate split screen mode by swiping 2 fingers from the bottom. You can also swipe directly from the top right corner to display the application in pop-up view. Then the next tip is to download the camera assistant application directly from the Galaxy Store. This is one of the essential applications that you should install on the S23 Ultra series in order to maximize the use of the camera on your smartphone. In the camera assistant application, there are many special camera settings that cannot be accessed directly from the default camera application. By installing the camera assistant application, you can enhance the power and optimize the use of your S23 Ultra camera according to your needs. For example, there is a capture speed setting that you can adjust to prioritize speed when taking photos. This will result in much faster speed than the standard setting. For other setting tips in the camera assistant application, maybe we will discuss them later in a dedicated video. Later, we will also compare some of the photos in several different settings. Then we will also share some tips on the most suitable camera settings for you to activate on the S23 Ultra in the camera assistant application. If the video is already available, you can check the link in the upper right corner of this video. Then the next tip is to install the Exporo application on the S23 Ultra to maximize the use of the camera. The Exporo feature in One UI 5.1 version on the S23 Ultra can be accessed via a shortcut in the camera application. However, if you haven't installed the Exporo application from the Galaxy Store, the shortcut may not appear the first time you use it. So you can install the Exporo application directly from the Galaxy Store. And then after installation, you can find a shortcut for the Exporo application in the More menu on the default camera application. The shortcut will connect to the Exporo application that you downloaded earlier. In the Exporo application, there are also several new features which have just been introduced, such as multiple exposure and astrophoto. To see example of how to use multiple exposure and astrophoto features, you can tap on the video that appears on your screen. Or you can also check out the latest One UI 5.1 features on another video that appears on your screen. Hopefully useful, see you in the next video.